Hello everyone, so welcome to this presentation of biochemistry of cartilage. We studied bone is a mineralized connective tissue. Similarly, cartilage is also a connective tissue, so it is also a connective tissue. And you should remember, cartilage is avascular. There is no blood vessels in the cartilage. Since it is avascular, it will derive its nutrients from adjacent tissue, maybe from synovial fluid, or maybe from the adjacent tissue. Okay, this is a avascular connective tissue, and it is soft and flexible. Whereas bone is a mineralized connective tissue, it is a hard, it is not flexible. Okay, as compared to bone, it is a soft and more flexible. And we will see this cartilage in almost like in the joints, ribs, especially end of the rib is a cartilage. And you can see ear, nose, and in between the vertebrae, or spine, and even airways, bronchus, bronchioles, we see this cartilage. Okay. So cartilage is a connective tissue, it is avascular, it derives its nutrients from the synovial fluid or maybe from the adjacent tissue or perichondrium. So now we will see there are three types of cartilage. So the first cartilage is called hyaline or articular cartilage. The second type is called elastic cartilage, and the last group is called fibroelastic. So there are three types of cartilage. So biochemistry of this cartilage is almost similar, some minor difference we will see that. Okay, hyaline cartilage is usually found in especially in the weight bearing joints, and it is very strong. This hyaline cartilage is very strong, and also it's a rubbery. So since it is rubbery, it is flexible. So this hyaline or articular cartilage is usually seen in weight bearing joints, and it is strong, tough, rubbery and flexible. Elastic cartilage, we'll see elastic cartilage in ear, larynx, even epiglottis. So all these places, whatever cartilage we are observing, that is elastic cartilage. Fibroelastic cartilage usually present in knee joint and in between the vertebrae in the spine. Whatever cartilage is between the two vertebrae, that cartilage is fibroelastic cartilage. Okay. We will see the biochemistry of this cartilage. So first we will see the composition of hyaline cartilage, then we will see there almost all cartilage have same composition with a minor difference. So the composition of the cartilage is, we can put it in two ways. One is collagen protein, like similar to bone, collagen proteins, and non-collagen proteins. So there are two types of proteins present in the cartilage. Yes, the collagen protein present in hyaline cartilage is type 2 collagen, and also we have type 5, type 6, type 9, type 10 and type 11. So among these, the major collagen, among collagen protein, 98% of collagen protein is type 2. That means these 5, 6, 9, 10, 11 are very minor amount. Okay. Among collagen proteins present in the hyaline. So first we'll see the composition of hyaline cartilage, then we'll go for elastic and fibroelastic. There are minor difference between these three cartilage, only amount and type of collagen. Okay. So hyaline or articular cartilage contains collagen proteins, and mainly type 2 collagen is the major collagen in hyaline cartilage. So 90 to 98% of collagen protein is type 2 collagen. Coming to non-collagen proteins, so this is collagen proteins. So coming to the non-collagen proteins, we have what is called as cartilage oligomeric matrix protein. In short, we can call them as COMP, okay, cartilage oligomeric matrix protein. Another type of non-collagen protein is proteoglycan. It is the name they have given is aggrecan. So aggrecan nothing but it is also called proteoglycan. So it is a type of proteoglycan. Proteoglycan is nothing but carbohydrate and protein. So the aggrecan is a proteoglycan. And we have chondronectin. This is also a non-collagen protein. Chondronectin. So this proteoglycan I will explain. The proteoglycan means it contains glycosaminoglycans, that is heteropolysaccharides, and it contains proteins. So this chondronectin actually it connects type 2 collagen to the, because we know that the major collagen protein is type 2 collagen, especially in hyaline cartilage. So it connects type 2 collagen to chondrocyte. So the cells present in the cartilage is called chondrocyte. We have osteocyte, osteoblast and osteoclast in bone. Similarly, we have a cells of cartilage is called chondrocyte. So chondronectin actually connects type 2 collagen to chondrocytes. So these are all composition of hyaline cartilage. In addition to this, in elastic cartilage, all this component will be there. This is common. In addition to this, similar to collagen, it is called elastin. This is also a protein. Collagen is also a protein. I will make a video on collagen. So elastic cartilage, in addition to collagen and non-collagen protein, it also contains a protein called elastin. Similarly, fibroelastic cartilage, in addition to this, it also contains type 1 collagen. Whereas articular cartilage or hyaline cartilage, we don't see type 1 cartilage. Here we have type 2 major and 5, 6, 9, 10, 11. And elastic also we will see all this collagen. But in fibroelastic cartilage, we have, in addition to this, we have type 1 collagen. That is the composition of this cartilage. So we will see more about this proteoglycan, aggrecan. Glycan, glycosidic bond, glycogen. So gly means carbohydrate, proteo means protein. They contain protein as well as carbohydrate. So it's actually, it contains heteropolysaccharide and a protein. So the example is aggrecan. So we studied in carbohydrate chemistry, especially in mucopolysaccharide or heteropolysaccharide. So we have hyaluronic acid. Hyaluronic acid, I'll write here. This is the hyaluronic acid. So in many of the heteropolysaccharides, we have what is called as core protein. So let me write here, core protein. This is our core protein. So this core protein, let me label it. So this is our core protein. When we say proteoglycan or glycoprotein, it should contain protein as well as carbohydrate. So here in this case, carbohydrate is actually mucopolysaccharides or glycosaminoglycans. In aggrecan, there are three types of glycosaminoglycans, GAGs. One is chondroitin sulfate, okay. So I explained in carbohydrate chemistry, they will be present in a brush border membrane, sorry. They present as bottle brush appearance, okay. Bottle brush appearance. So these are actually heteropolysaccharides or glycosaminoglycans, and these are actually chondroitin sulfate. We studied actually under carbohydrate chemistry, many of the glycosaminoglycans are sulfated. Okay, all these green colors are chondroitin sulfate. And we also have in aggrecan glycosaminoglycans, also we have what is called keratin sulfate. In the cartilage, we have chondroitin sulfate. We have keratin sulfate, okay, keratin sulfate, okay, this is, let me write here, this is another GAG, glycosaminoglycan. It is not keratin, it is keratin sulfate. We also have, this is actually our blue color, this one is hyaluronic acid, this is another glycosaminoglycan. Now this is a core protein, this is hyaluronic acid. In between there is a protein called, this is called link protein. And also we can see some carbohydrates, oligosaccharides, you can see here and here, somewhere here you can see. These are all oligosaccharides. So this is actually our aggregan of proteoglycan, where this binding of this hyaluronic acid and core protein or link protein is not strong bond, it is actually non-covalent bond. So that means, in other words, core protein is bound to hyaluronic acid non-covalent. It is loosely attached to hyaluronic acid and link protein. Non-covalently attached to this hyaluronic acid. Which one? This core protein and link protein are attached to hyaluronic acid. They are attached loosely. Whereas this chondroitin sulfate, this actually chondroitin sulfate attached to core protein, here it is covalently attached. And here one more interesting thing, so this aggregan has three domain. So the hyaluronic acid attached to core protein, this is domain A, whereas this keratin sulfate attachment to the core protein is domain B, and chondroitin sulfate attachment is domain C. So there are three domains in the aggregan. You can see the core protein loosely attached to hyaluronic acid with a link protein, that is domain A. The keratin sulfate is attached to a portion of core protein, it will become domain B. These are all domain. And the chondroitin sulfate, which is covalently attached to the core protein, which is called domain C. This is actually structure of aggregan or proteoglycan. In a cartilage, so usually collagen will be like this. Imagine this is a collagen. The structure of collagen, I'll make one video. It is a triple helix. And this in between collagen, we have link protein. Okay, we have hyaluronic acid. So this is actually our hyaluronic acid. Whereas this will become our link protein. And the attachment of link protein and hyaluronic acid is not covalent, it is loosely or non-covalently attached. So this green color is our core protein. This is our core protein. And we have many glycosaminoglycans are attached to this core protein. So this will become our, these two are collagen. These are all chondroitin sulfate. So these two picture is actually, this is collagen. So majority is type 2 collagen. This is actually core protein, this is link protein, this red color is link protein. And this core protein, this blue color thing which is attached is, these are all glycosaminoglycans, especially chondroitin, keratin sulfate. Okay. Same thing I have drawn here. So if you take this small portion, so that will be explained here. That is what I have explained here. Okay, we have core protein, chondroitin sulfate, keratin sulfate, and this is hyaluronic acid. So hyaluronic acid, keratin sulfate, chondroitin sulfate are the glycosaminoglycans, to which this core protein and link protein is a protein component of this proteoglycan. That's about composition or biochemistry of cartilage. Thanks for watching.